Autism Insights is an effort from members and supporters of the VenusProject.com resource-based economy and is not an official spokesperson, representative, or act in any official capacity and serves only to encourage, support, and motivate other TVP activists.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Activism Insights, the show that's dedicated to those out in the field, the activists, working to help spread awareness and to help others learn about this direction. This is in July of 2017. A very, very special guest again on the show. I'd like to introduce, I think a lot of people are already familiar or know, Jennifer Hugh. And it's Hughes, isn't it?
Hughes, yeah.
All right, let's get it straight, Lukey. Right. So we welcome you and thank you for taking the time. We know that you have a lot on your plate. There's a lot going on, and it really doesn't matter where you are because you travel the country. You've gone out of the country, so she's always busy. And we just thank you for taking the time to share with us. And we just look forward to listening and to some of the things you'll share with us. Like I do with every guest, if you will, tell us, you know, your name, what part of the world you're residing in currently, and then, you know, how you found out about the VenusProject.com resource-based economy, Jock and Roxanne.
Okay. Well, first, thanks for having me. And, of course, thanks for what you're doing with this podcast. It's very... very helpful. So I appreciate that and all of the things that you do for the Venus Project.
Of course. Yeah.
So my name is Jennifer Hughes, and I currently at this very moment I'm in Denver.
Okay.
I'll be here for about another week, and then I'll be in New Jersey. So I first found out about the Venus Project actually from Future by Design, which is one of our documentaries, and it was at the time that it was available on Netflix. So okay. I was just looking through documentaries on Netflix, and it looked very interesting. And then after I watched it, basically, I just knew that I had to contact them and help them, because that was the best proposal that I had seen for fixing the issues in the world thus far.
So. And I'm also curious because you had helped a little bit personally with Jock in therapy and things like that. So was that emotionally kind of trying to... you know, to this great guy that goes through, a human body goes through, and was it uplifting, or, you know, tell us a little bit about that.
I'd say I've been working with, trying to help with therapy when I went down there and things like that, for roughly the last, 6 years or so. We live at the research center too. So, that's one of the places we live. So, I would be down there trying to do anything that I could to help with all of there's so much to do when you're down there. But, since I did have a background in that, I tried to help Jock with that because he passed away at 101. So, even though he was very, very good shape. He was, in the best shape I've ever seen. You still, like you said, just normal biological processes of aging, unfortunately, can cause you to hurt, and things like that. So it was very rewarding that I was able to help him, to not be in as much discomfort after all he did for the world. It's the least that I could do at all was try to help him be more comfortable. So it was emotionally, I mean, it was wonderful, you know, to spend the time with him. I got to spend a lot of very personal time with him, you know, and talk with him and stuff. And so emotionally, that aspect of it, you know, is wonderful. It's hard, of course, to see someone that is so brilliant and so caring of the world and things like that and about everybody to be in pain, you know, in any pain at all, or even just aging at all, because you know, once it starts to get to that age, that something could happen, you know, at any time. So, you know, that part was hard. And of course, when he passed, it was, you know, very hard. Roxanne and I were there at the hospital, you know, through everything and stuff. So that part's hard.
Yeah,
it's still hard. Right after he passed away, I actually wound up getting sick a couple days after and had to go deal with that and stuff like that. So I don't know if I had too much time to process it, but so that part was hard.
You were a huge help. And I mean, but you've been doing this for years, 6 years or more. And currently you're in a very important position, which is the social media and marketing coordinator. We know just how important that is to market, to be able to reach people, a lot of processes, a whole lot of steps and procedures in order to reach the media, to reach human beings. What can you tell us about that and how long you've been doing it?
I've been doing that for some years now too. I started out helping in social media, and then I started helping with some things, just with trying to help organize and set up different departments and things like that. And I became a coordinator. We've since brought on, you know, other coordinators and things like that to help, because obviously these kinds of things can't all just be on one person, you know, as we're expanding with something so, you know, something so large. So we brought on other people to help coordinate and help do things like that. And we're currently also in the process of restructuring really the entire organization. So what we are setting up is we're trying to get away. Originally we used coordinators to try to take, you know, just from, not even as a hierarchy type of position, but more so for one team to be able to communicate with another team. So for instance, if social media is working with graphics or video or something like that, we have kind of one or a couple people that can liaison with them instead of having, you know, all the members of the team trying to reach out and things like that. So that's really what that those roles that we developed were for. But now with the processes that we're putting into place with reorganizing, we're trying to have set up a platform that is a more project management format, so that people will be able to kind of see everything, all of the projects that we're working on, all of the areas that still need help, you know, where they can help out, you know, what these things are, and they can kind of look at it so easily that we won't even, probably we're looking to even not have to have coordinators anymore, because everybody will be able to interact with each other, you know, straight off the projects and things like that that need to get done. So, which is pretty cool, you know, because so that's a big undertaking. We've been working on that one department at a time because we have to transition everything over to the new software that we're using to be able to lay this out for everyone.
Cool.
And also with that, implement a lot of new procedures. So we're basically developing these new procedures for this new project management platform and things that we're going to have for it also, because, you know, we were doing it a different way. So now
Sure.
we're refining it. So, you know, and we started with the graphics team. That's been going really well. So now we are moved on to the social media team, and we are that's going well. And then we'll, you know, be working on, you know, we're working on all of them. So one at
Got
a
it,
time.
son.
So human resources, you know, video, everything like that. So and in combination with that, we also have been developing a new online education program, which I think Sasha spoke to you about on his podcast.
Yeah, excellent.
Which would, yeah, it's going to enable a lot more people to be able to volunteer. You know, to be able to go, a lot of the setups we had in the past, we've had to have people that were very educated in the Venus Project and a resource-based economy work with the people directly to be able to educate them. So, you know, people can only work with a certain amount of people and get it, you know, in a proper way. So the way that we're setting it up now is a lot more automated. With being able to have people come online and complete a good portion of the education to come and, you know, start doing bigger things with the with the organization. Yeah, so it's pretty cool. It's a pretty exciting time because we're really starting to be able to open it up more for people to help in all these areas,
Fantastic.
Which will be great. Yeah, it'll be great. You know, because as of now, obviously, it's been, you know, a core group, if you will. You know, it started just with Jacques, and then Roxanne helped, and then, you know, we've had, you know, some core people, and then it's been growing and growing and growing. And now, you know, between, especially with activism and things like that, I mean, we have volunteers in over 50 countries. Now, which is, it's wonderful. You know, they're helping with activism and different things. And so many of these people have so much different skills and talents and things like that, that as we're refining things and streamlining things and making it easier to get through these processes, you know, it saves some time on things that they're doing, and they can even look at a project that we have and say, oh, I can help on that. You know, like,
right
too,
on.
You know,
yeah.
I have, you know, I have this. So by laying that out, you know, and then, like I said, making things more streamlined, it saves their time. And, you know, they can be working on activism in Chile, you know, and be
right,
like, oh,
right,
okay, well,
right.
This got streamlined,
exactly.
So I have less time. Oh, yeah, I have a graphics background. I'll go help on that little project, you know, and it's nice. So it should be, really, really good at helping all these people to help, even if they have limited time, you know, because
yeah,
in this format, you know, we'll be able to see the projects, and you can see, like, you know, some of them are quick projects, you know, but we just need people that have that experience in it, you know, so they can come and help it out, or, you know, maybe take one project that's more long term and work on it with people or something. So
right,
it's going to give a lot of variety, which is
well, in
really nice
social stuff. Media, the term, you know, for me, there was a stereotypical Facebook, YouTube, you know, this. What does that mean when we talk about social media? What does that kind of entail?
Well, you're not far off base with what you're saying. You know, it is. It's mainly social media is a form of marketing. You know, there's a lot of different types of marketing. You can have radio marketing or television marketing or billboard marketing or, you know, this and that. And that social media marketing is when you're developing content, you know, to be placed out on these different networks, like you mentioned, like Facebook and Twitter and, you know, Google Plus, just so many different ones around the world. And it's what it is trying to get content or information out on these networks and reach as many people as possible that are on these networks so they can see it, you know, and get that information that you're creating out so that it actually reaches, you know, the eyes of people through these social media networks.
Okay.
So
there's Twitter, there's YouTube, And I wasn't real, I'm not a, I don't do any tweeting. I just, you know, there's certain areas I haven't really delved into, but I know that there's a support for the Twitter movement, and okay, and then there's YouTube, and then there's Facebook. What else is there?
Instagram,
Okay.
Pinterest, those are networks, and each network has a little kind of thing about it, you know, that might have people more interested in that network
Yes,
than, say, another one network. So
absolutely.
Twitter, like you mentioned, is one where it's very short. You know, there's character limits, and you just kind of very quickly tweet out something, you know, and that's it. You know, Instagram, Pinterest, they're more graphics based, where
Okay.
you're really just kind of Instagram's more graphics based, where you're really just kind of sharing a graphic, you
Okay.
know. So, and it's all it is. It doesn't really have all this chatting and things and stuff, you know, incorporated with it. There's some commenting and stuff, but Pinterest too is sort of along those lines. You know, you can put links and things like that. But, you know, some people just want to, you know, just look at an image and, you know, they see the image and a little comment under it or something, and, you know, they prefer that. There's ones like LinkedIn where it's mainly more business oriented, where you, say, for example, you can more so like reach out to business people on that network. Or not just business people, but professionals, if you're, you know, looking maybe for someone to help you or something like that. But yeah, and I mean, all of this, I have to say too, all of this that has been going on so far to help Jacques and Roxanne to develop this idea, you know, and get it around the world and get these different things. One thing I think I find very interesting is it's all volunteers. Everyone's volunteers, you know, all around the world. So all of these hours and things that are developed and stuff, it's donated by people that really believe that this is the direction that we should go. So, you know, it's being done with a almost nothing budget, you know.
A
So,
lot of
you
hard
know,
work and dedication from the people that comprise what the movement is about. Well, maybe what we should do, and we'll make available, we'll do links to LinkedIn, we'll do links to Twitter, to tweet, or what is it called?
Twitter, yeah.
Twitter. All right. Lukey's a little slow. And so we'll
That's
put links up to every bit of the different social media. And it seems like, as you were describing, there's a lot of opportunity for people, because a lot of us are saying, like, well, what do I do? You know, I'm out here doing the streets, but I want to do more. I just think that there's things that, and you know, the society kind of you know, debases people thinking that they don't have skills, and every single person has a tremendous amount of skills that they just may not realize yet. And do you, so there's opportunity within the social marketing. Do you need help, or are there different departments, or how does that work if somebody wants to become involved? What is there, what's happening?
We need help in every department. So, I mean,
Okay.
there will probably not reach a level with something that is a project of this magnitude where we will ever run out of needing help.
Okay.
I don't think
Right.
that's going to happen for quite some time. You know, there may be a project that finishes that we no longer need any help on because that project is done or completed. But as far as working in the departments and everywhere, we're always going to need help in all of them.
Okay.
Right now, we are also, like I mentioned, simultaneously, as we're doing the restructuring, setting up the HR department. So originally, what we were doing before was we were having people email each of the department, whatever department they wanted to work in, and then, you know, they could just go through it that way. But now we have everybody; it just goes through HR. So
Okay,
anyone
human
that's looking,
resources. All
anyone
right.
that's looking to help in any department, really, can email HR@thevenusproject.com, and then they'll speak with our team members there. We'll get their information and put it for them. They'll get them a non-disclosure agreement, you know, to sign. And then after that's completed, they'll send them to the department that they're interested in working with.
Out of
And
sight.
yeah, and we have
Very good.
some very, simple but helpful education orientations going on for people too that are starting the new teams. Just some brief things, to get them started. We obviously have much more extensive courses that people want to go through and things like that too. But these are just an orientation, which pretty much happens when you start working with any organization. So if anyone wants to help at all, they can email hr@thevenusproject.com, and they'll be able to speak with them and find out more a lot about their interests and experience and background, and help them develop where they would like to go help. And if you want to work in maybe not in the global teams or in the global teams and activism, you can also speak to people in your area. You can admin@thevenusproject.com. They'll be able to help give the names of the local points of contact in your area. We also have a list on our website of all the different emails of the points of contact. If you're in Brazil or Chile or wherever, and you want to work as an activist, you can email them and you can get started there. Helping with them too. So basically either hr@thevenusproject.com or admin@thevenusproject.com. So
cool. And it sounds like we're going to start hearing a lot more about the human resources department, or at the top of it, that disseminates the information where people can go, kind of help them to see where they may best suited with whatever skills or desires that they have to help. And so it sounds like we'll be learning a lot more about, and is the term just HR, the HR department, or the HR head? That's very interesting. Very cool.
So there's a lot going on. And we're also, which Roxanne announced at the United Nations award that Jacques received last year. We also have the nonprofit organization that they have set up that's going to be directly aimed at working with the development of the first city and then the subsequent cities.
Whoa.
So that organization is also being worked on, which is, it's called RBE, resource-based economy. And those are both being worked on, both RBE and TBP. So, there's a lot going on. And it's really great to see. There's just been, even in the 6 or so years that I've been working with them, just the response that I can see from interactions with people online, in person, everywhere, and I didn't have too much resistance even, but I did have, but I did notice lately that there's just so many more people that are interested in this type of direction. I think they're just, over it, over the way stuff is going, and they're very interested in this direction, and a lot of people want to help. And it's just been increasing over the years, which is really nice. It's nice to see.
So I bet we're going to hear a lot more about RBE, too, as it begins more development, where there's a point things can be released. So we'll be looking forward to that.
Totally.
Yeah, it's really exciting.
How exciting.
Yeah, I know, it really is. And Roxanne's busting her ass on that, of course, as she busts her ass on everything.
Everything, always has.
Everything.
I know. She's amazing.
Her ass on everything. I know. So she's, doing that, and so everybody is kind of plugging along, and anybody that wants to help, we would love to work with.
And we'll have links on that for all those different people who are real good, who are working with Tweet. What is it called again?
Twitter. Yeah, wait.
All right. Twitter. Because there's a lot of our supporters that are involved with it, and they have been. So they could be very instrumental. People that are familiar with all the different techniques of Facebook, people that are familiar with these areas that we need help. This is a great place for people to become involved, to work with others that are in the same mode that you are, with the same goals and the same directives. So we'll put links to all of that. And is there... So that would take care of the social media. Now, what can you tell us about, you know, when with those that are out in the field, do you have any suggestions on approaches, or, you know, those that are out there doing it, you know, what can you say to them? You know, all of
us. Well, I just want to say to everybody too, even if you're not necessarily working right now with the global teams or with activism too, I also want to just mention that everything that everybody does is important. You know, even if people are just sharing posts or things like that, or reaching out to one person, or maybe inviting their friends to the page, you know, take 5 minutes and invite, you know, 10 people, because we set, you know, a lot too. Sometimes we have little campaigns, you know, just if you can invite 10 people, you know, we'd go from 300,000 people to, you know, 3 million and very quickly, right. You know, these kinds of things. So, but there's little small things that, or maybe considered small, I should say, that people do. I just want people to know that it's not small. You know, it's very important. All of these little things are important. They may not seem like it, but the more that people start seeing it, even if it's just a post in your feed, you're like, hey, I saw that in like four of my friends' feeds. You know, what is this Venus Project thing, you know, or whatever. Absolutely. You know, so all of those are important. Talking to people is important. If you are out there working locally, being an activist, it is very helpful to work with the activism team if you can, even if you are not a point of contact or something like that, but to work with your local team, or if you don't have a local team yet and you can't be a point of contact yet, just still be in touch with the activism team, because they have a lot of brochures, they have a lot of you know, experience with help on what to say on certain topic, you know, things like that. So you know, flyers and things for banners and stuff and whatever is being done there, and they can help set up events and things like that. But I'd also say too, just, you know, try not to get discouraged. I know some people do get discouraged, because sometimes maybe the area or region that they're in, or family that they're in, or something like that, or might not be receptive, you know, to it. And sometimes they can get discouraged. So it is really great to link up with other people that are doing it, you know, for the support. But also to, you know, to keep in mind that some people are going to turn you down. Like, there's going to be people that are negative to it. And on our end, we might not understand, like, how could you not want that?
Yeah, right.
You know, how could you not want this? But but depending on what their circumstances or backgrounds or values are, there's a lot of different reasons you might not be able to get through to them at that time, you know, but you can mention it, drop a seed. And again, like I said, later they start seeing it with a bunch of people, and they're like, wait, I remember, you know, the person spoke to me about it, or something like that. But, and then you go put your real energies on the people that are receptive to it, you know, because if you just put, hammer your energies on people that are committed to resisting it right now, that can take your energy, you know. So to just, you know, kind of keep in mind that if someone is resistant, you mention it a little bit, you know, and keep going, you know. Don't, but because I noticed that when people first find out about it, and I did the same thing, you know, but when people first find out about it, you know, they want to tell everybody, and they can't believe, like, why their corporate, you know, religious father is not interested at that moment, you know, or something like that, you know, and then it can be upsetting. But so, you know, you have to just kind of, I have a friend of mine actually that is and I've been talking to him about it kind of for years, and just because I was surprised, but because really recently, you know, he changed his mind from saying that he didn't think that, you know, it would work because of the getting rid of money aspect. He liked a lot of the other aspects, but he didn't think it would work because of that. And, you know, just very recently, you know, he was like, I don't see any other way this can go. And this is because, you know, I talked with him about little bits over time, you know, but, and I was amazed, you know, so just do that. And then to also constantly work on yourself and work on yourself on trying to become the best communicator that you can. Because the more that you work on becoming a good communicator, the more you're going to be able to talk to people and relate with their values. So if you're able to find out what their values are, you can speak to them about how their values are covered in this project. If you're talking to them about a value that they have absolutely no interest in, it's not going to be as appealing to them as talking to them about something that concerns them. And this project covers everything.
Yeah.
It covers everything. So you know, you most likely are going to be able to find something, you know, that is relatable at least. So, but again, you know, so that's, you know, my suggestions for people that are out there.
Yeah, so and far, it's a know. Good illustration is that they, you know, only have so much information. And whatever reason, they reject it initially, but it just seems that the more information they get, even if you're not around them all the time, if they get a few seeds, and I just love that term, because then they get it a little bit later, or they see what you've said in the newspaper, or they hear it, and it begins to become real. Their range of knowledge on that particular becomes more increased, and they have a better ability to understand it. I just, you know, and I, we're so enthusiastic with most people when they find out about this, cause they're like, you know, how, you know, let's do the city, you know, I'm ready to go. Let's leave this behind. And, you know, we'll get into about building a city. Most people know our values aren't there. And actually we're working on that. We're working on making that happen. But you know, our enthusiasm, is, you know, so intense. And it can be, like you said, don't be discouraged, you know. It takes a while for people, because you got it right now is because of your influences. And if we keep influencing people and bringing this direction and the solutions to them over and over, they will get it. And you know, so.
Don't take it personal either. You know, don't take it, you know, personal. It's. You're trying to get them a message, but like you said, whatever their values are. And the other thing that I say, you know, it can feel frustrating at times or things like that. But then, like, if I start to get frustrated or tired or something, I just kind of, like, my go-to thing is that, like, Jacques was doing this by himself for the longest time. Everybody was laughing at him. They thought he was fucking nuts. You know, with his designs and magnetic levitation and things and whatever. And they're like, they didn't even have internet, you know. Totally. He didn't even have internet to try to get his message out. And then Roxanne came and helped them. And, like, they still didn't even have internet, you know. And they were working, like, that's mind-blowing to me, like, you know, and working on this. So, and, you know, they didn't give up, and they could have completely gave up on us. Like, all the adversity that they faced and all the different things, you know, they could have just been like, you know, fuck it, who cares, you know, and they didn't. Yeah. So, if they didn't, you know, and now we have all this technology to get the message out there, and we have so much more support around the world than, you know, they ever did for the large majority of when they were doing it, then, you know, I mean, I mean, I'm not going to get too frustrated. You know, I'll go.
You got
take
a
it
lot
out
of tools,
something.
Yes, a lot of tools, and a lot of other
support. Think about what they went through, and where it went from where they were to where it is now. So if all of us aren't giving up, then just imagine where it's going to go to. You know,
totally, and it can feel hurtful if our own parents or our own friends, you know, you become ostracized, you know. Or ridiculed, it can hurt if you don't understand where they're coming from. often people love you so much that they don't want to lose your friendship. They value you. They want to be, you know, have you as a friend. They love you. And so they don't, you know, things they don't understand, they may feel threatened or left behind. So, you know, and like you said, listen to people when they're talking to you to see where they're coming from. What are their values? What is it that, you know, means something to them? And you can help them. You can help them to see that this is real. You know, just the example of millions of people around the world donating their time who are so dedicated to it and spend their own time instead of other stuff is a great example. And when we're working with each other, man, when we're talking the same language, you know, it's difficult. Jock often says, you know, somebody smart ends up becoming dumb to talk to those around him or around you because they're not on the same level. Their thoughts are on, you know, whatever their title, their new car, or whatever it is, their values. And so talking with other activists, becoming involved in some of these different areas that need help, like social media, you begin to work with other people, and that reinstills your enthusiasm again. You realize you're not alone. You see more of it. And that can help you. We know how important it is to develop a team wherever we are. And so that can help you do that. And the more you do anything, the easier it becomes, right? Talking to people, having a fluid delivery. The more you do it, the better you get.
And it's, you know, also I think another thing to keep in mind too is, a couple of things that, like, this is not a, this is a constant refinement for ourselves. Like, we constantly want to try to refine ourselves to be better speakers and better communicators and things like that. It's not really something that ends, you know, if you're into this kind of thing, it isn't something that should end for you. You know, you should be trying to work on those type of things and your understanding and you know, basically as close to a peaceful conflict resolution person as you could be, you know, so those kinds of, and that, you know, when you are a conflict negotiator or, you know, peace negotiator or anything like that, you know, you have to really see their other sides and be very patient about things, or you're not going to be able to resolve the conflict. So, you know, anything that we can keep working on ourselves when it comes to this, because there will be such extreme differences in mindset that we're going to come to, but, you know, by talking to people in 258 countries around the world. So just keep working on that. And also, you know, another thing is, you know, we all want to build the cities today. We wish the cities were built already, you know, so, but it's a totally. Process, you know, all right. this is what we're talking about here is not inventing a new product, which is complicated enough in itself, you know, or a new idea or something. This is literally changing the entire global operating system of the planet. So, you know, and cities are, you know, so cities are a good basis to where we can show people on a bigger scale more and more what we propose. But even that is not the whole thing. The cities are not the whole, you know, thing here. So it's a very big undertaking. And it's something that has never been done before. So, you know, so just have patience too. Have patience, you know, with people. I'll have patience with that, you know, and just keep in mind, again, you know, how much further along we are, you know, since it started.
Yeah, absolutely. The tools that we have at our disposal and the tools that are made available through the Venus Project organization. Once you begin to become involved, and we'll come back to that. I would think it'd be helpful again to reiterate how important it is to continue the education. That would sometimes, you know, it seems like, wow, now I get it. And then you read another chapter or you review a new video and you're like, whoa, you know, there's a lot more to learn. So constantly.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. And why it's important to look into the POC training and eventually perhaps, or even start with, the socio-cyberneering educational training for the POC. You know, we would always recommend anyone who really has decided to take time in their lives to make a serious effort in some area, that POC is a good training to start with, isn't it?
Absolutely. Yeah. Anyone that's really wanting to be active in their area, that would be a really good training for them to go through. Again, like you said, it's good for everybody to go through, but especially, you know, that course is looking for people that are going to develop the local groups in their area. So, yeah, that's really good. Socio-cyber engineering course is something that everybody should try to take if possible. You know, right now, everybody can't take it because we're limited on the number of people that can teach this, because this course is right now does have to be followed up on with an actual human being as you're going through it. So what happens with a lot of these courses and the POC courses too is that, you know, as the people go through them and graduate, then they're able to teach and then they're able to take more people into the courses and things like that. So that's what's going on too, which is interesting. But
even their training helps to develop the newer training. What we've learned, how can we streamline, where there were problems. Everyone becomes, again, a contributor. And we, you know, we just don't want to say, hey, everybody, you know, be a POC. If you decide to do it, it means a serious effort. And my experience, I'm taking a POC training, is that I have a guide. I have somebody like a mentor who is following everything I'm doing and helping when I have problems. And it does take time. And it's we think that it's difficult to find time to do things. Well, I'm so busy already, but I might point out for those who still watch TV that they're always at that, you know, they're sitting in front of that couch, you know, when that game comes on, you know, they're the things that are important to them, they do. And so we should make people aware that the POC training is very serious. It takes time. You don't want to start it and just, oh, I decide I'm not going to do it, because, you know, we're trying to develop the training. Your experience of the training helps develop other training. And so, and it doesn't necessarily mean that you're relegated to being a POC. You may, as you develop a stronger understanding, you may say, hey, I totally fit in for social media, or I totally fit in linguistic. I totally fit in this area. So it's not relegated. What is your commitment to doing the training, to showing up and doing the homework. There's a lot of homework, which is fantastic. Look, I mean, you know, sometimes if we're upset and, hey, everybody around here is a bunch of knuckleheads, they don't know nothing, everybody's negative, and we start listening to some of Jock's tapes, you know, I mean, you start getting re-enthused, and you remember why you're doing it. You may look at your own daughter or your son, your dad, or this earth, and realize why you're doing it. And so it is intensified training. I'm loving it, and I would encourage everybody to seriously look into it. And we will, and again, here again, you're interacting. You're interacting with other members and supporters who have invested that time, who have a lot of knowledge to share and help you to become more and to become more effective, to have a fluid and you know, responsive and spontaneous the ability to explain to others who don't know about it. So we always want to emphasize that. And it's a wonderful training, and there's a whole lot of stuff coming up on the horizon. Tons of back work. I mean, you can't really tell them everything we're still developing. We like to make sure that it's in a presentable form so that it's comprehensive, so that people can understand what it's about. So it's just so exciting.
So much back work. Much back work that people don't see, you know, to do all of the different things that we're doing. And again, as I mentioned, it's on a completely almost volunteer basis. You know, once in a while for a project like the documentary or something like that, we'll raise money, and the supporters are always great about, you know, something like that. But you know, that goes right for the project. You know, so and that's really also it's nice. Yeah. And as you mentioned, with these courses, you know, we're trying to teach people, you know, so that they're educated about this. So there is time that's involved with doing these courses and things like that, because obviously we're trying to push people that are going, or people that are going through it, to get as much education as possible, because they are going to be, like you said, giving feedback on how can we refine it, going out and teaching other people, you know, things like that. So yeah, there is homework.
It's a tremendous tool, and we've reached that point. And we also want to acknowledge the fact that though there are others that are involved in different departments that we're not so much yet aware of, that what we are doing out in the field and how important that is. It's part of an entire interlocked project to help transition. And every single person has tremendous potential. And, you know, we never know who we talk to that could be an incredible activist who goes on, who has a following that we don't even know about, and influences thousands, if not millions of people. So every single effort is important. And I just wish we could learn. I mean, hey, here I'm in Chicago. Next week I'm going to be in Florida. And then next week I'm going to be in New Jersey. And then next week. So when you say you live a place, you're just there temporarily till the next assignment, right?
Yeah.
Oh, didn't you guys just do a California trip?
Yeah.
And did a whole bunch of documentary, did interviews with some very cool. We'll be learning more about that. We'd like to have interview with Nate, because Nate is, for those who don't know, Nathaniel Dinwillis, he's involved with the archive, he's involved with the movie, he's involved with Jock's historic, life and documentary. So we'd like to do an interview. He can give us more about that, couldn't he?
Nate's another rock star out there.
And I mean, it must have been a whirlwind trip for you guys. What was it, a week, 2 weeks?
About a week. I think it was.
I don't know how you did it.
Maybe 10 days, maybe.
I mean, you got from one end of the state to the other. You actually even went out of state, right? Arizona. Was there a trip to Arizona to a guy that was?
Nate and Sasha went to that.
Unbelievable. Well, it's good to be young, right? Well, I know so many of us out here so appreciate what you're doing. So many of us appreciate what all of the activists are doing. We're all part of a large effort. And, you know, it's all dependent upon us stepping up and doing whatever it is we can do. If we don't do anything, when you do something, someone else does something. It's almost like that's me, you know. So when you help in that area, you're part of the entire transition, and just so important.
Little bit helps. Every little bit adds up and grows it, you know, and it just leads to exponential growth. So anything that people can do is helpful. You know, we're going to be trying to have more and more of what we can put out for people to do, as much as we can, to having that out. You know, even just signing up for the newsletter, you know.
Yes.
Maybe you can forward a newsletter to someone, you know what I mean? Like I said, like invite 10 people to the page, you know, that'll take you under 5 minutes, but it might expose 10 more people. And then, you know, or even if a few of them actually go to the page, say 5 of the 10 go to the page or something like that, and 3 of the people like it, but then they share it to 10 more people. You know, I mean, these little things. So there's really something that everybody can do to help, even if their time is limited to do maybe more intensive things right now. But we have a lot of cases where people do, you know, certain things, and then as their time allows, they can take on more stuff. And then if their time changes again, they go down to, you know, smaller amount that they're contributing. But it's all helpful.
Every single effort is so important. Don't let what society.
And the only way it'll happen is if we do it. Like, this is the thing. If this is the future that you want, the only way we're getting this future is by us working on this. Because the current operating system is not just going to put this future in place.
It can't. It can only reinforce itself. Yeah. No shit.
But we have to decide, like, the world that we want to live in. You know, we can't just sit around and hope it gets there.
Right. And then also even just some of the very fundamental basics, which would be to read the book, The Best That Money Can't Buy.
Jacques says, read it twice.
My fourth read. And I mean, it takes time to read it and comprehend it, retain it, and be able to recall it. but the more times that you do it, and every single time I read it, I just get more out of it. It's so entailing and in depth. The size and scope of what we're doing is so immense that often I think it's people think that it's overwhelming, and it isn't. And in addition, that there's every one of us are ready to help with whatever we can do to help each other. And so it's just such a wonderful, wonderful thing. And it's all real. It's all based on people who care, people who they're not making a buck from it. I mean, they're taking out of their own lives. So that says a lot.
I think what you just brought up was a really good point too, though. But you know, that every time you read the book again, there's something that pops out, or every time you watch a video or a lecture or something, there's something that pops out more to you, because you might not understand it at first because you've never been exposed to the concept. So certain things will come out, but then as you study more and you go back to the thing and you're like, oh, I get that. And it just opens your mind up more, you know, to be able to, you're just like, I didn't even, get that the first time, you know,
Absolutely.
Yeah. Because, I mean, trying to be able to, Jacques' brain is, you know.
How deep down that rabbit hole shall we go? You know, I mean, you could look forever. It's so immense.
Amazing,
we're still learning. Well, I sure thank you. I thank you for everything you're doing. I know that everybody feels the same way. We'll also put her Facebook. If you're not already a friend, please become her friend. You'll get her feeds. You'll see some of the things that she posts and updates. You know, of course, we always will like what she had said. Make sure you sign up for that newsletter from the VenusProject.com website. So I just thank you, and I know everyone does, and we'll look forward. We'd like to have another interview a little bit further down the line when you're ready and you've got some stuff you need to help the activists know through this channel anyway. Always ready there to support you. Just so value you, and I'm thankful that you're involved in all the things that you've done, even in the personal things that you've done to help Jock with his body, with his spirit, and reading to him and lifting, you know, helping him. I say spirit, what I really mean, there again, language. So, but just the effort and being, you know, there, taking time out of your life to be there for him and help is just so wonderful. And it had,
it's the least I could do. It's the least I can do after all he did, you know. It was amazing. Time with him was invaluable.
Can only imagine. So, well, I thank you, Jennifer, and we're going to come back to you. You'll have some new stuff, and we just appreciate what you're doing, and thank you for this interview. This is going to wrap it up for Activism Insights, and we both thank you for joining and look forward to seeing you at the next show. Thanks so much, Jennifer.
Thanks for all you do, too, of course, again.
Sure. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
For more information on the VenusProject.com resource-based economy, log on to the VenusProject.com website or check out the VenusProject.com YouTube channels and Facebook pages.